A bad power steering pump seal can cause one of two problems. If fluid is leaking out, you'll get a line of fluid on the bottom of your hood right here. If air is being pulled in, you'll get fluid bubbling out of the reservoir. So if the outside of your reservoir is always soaked, you'll know air is getting pulled into the system. You just need this seal. Unbolt and unplug the cruise control actuator and set it out of the way. This part is important. The power steering pulley bolt is left-hand thread, so you gotta rotate it clockwise to loosen it. Try and break it free now while the belt's still tensioned. You can stick a screwdriver through one of the pulley holes to help hold it as well. Just find a good spot where it won't damage anything. Once the bolt is loose, just leave it finger tight for now. Now you need to loosen the 14mm adjuster pulley nut. The clearance is tight, so a long, straight, box-end wrench like this would be best. Here's the adjuster pulley nut. It's a regular thread, so counterclockwise to loosen. Don't take it all the way off, just a few turns to loosen it. Now you need to loosen the adjusting bolt that's stuffed up under the alternator. Pop out this plastic plug that's behind the headlight. Now get a 12mm swivel socket and a bunch of extensions like this. Feed it between the headlight and the body, through the hole, under the alternator, and onto the bolt. Now loosen the bolt to take tension off the belt, then pull the belt off the pulley once it's loose enough. Unscrew the pulley bolt and remove the pulley. Place rags under the opening to catch any fluid, then reach in with a pick and pull out the seal. It's really important you don't touch the shaft with the pick. If you damage it where the seal rides, the pump is pretty much ruined because it'll never seal right. A safer way of doing it is removing the front of the pump by removing these four bolts. There'll be a link in the description with info on that. Wipe the power steering fluid out of the housing and inspect it to make sure it's clean. Get a deep socket that has a diameter that's just slightly smaller than the seal, and make sure it'll fit down into the housing without touching the shaft. The new seal will come with a little bit of grease on the inside. Smear it around and then loop up the bottom of the seal a little bit. Now carefully pop the seal onto the shaft, then inspect it to make sure the lip's even all the way around. Using the socket and a hammer, carefully tap the seal down till it fully seats. Then inspect it to make sure it's straight and not sitting crooked. It's hard to see, but the pulley hole has a little flat spot, so it'll only go on one way. Install the pulley and snug down the bolt the best you can. Install the belt and make sure it's sitting in the crank and pulley adjuster grooves correctly. Now tighten the adjuster fairly tight so that the pulley is held in place while you tighten the bolt. Torque the bolt to 24 foot-pounds or 33 newton-meters. Loosen the adjuster to have about 3/8 inch or 10mm of deflection here in the belt. It's better if it's too loose than too tight. If it squeaks, you can always tighten it more later. pull out the ratchet and reinstall the plug. Tighten the adjuster pulley nut. You won't be able to get a torque wrench on it, so just use your best judgment. Now reinstall the cruise control actuator. Double check your work and you're done. I would clean off any fluid that's leaked previously, then keep an eye on it and make sure you fix the problem.